define an associative array to hold an entire row from a table. Here we declare type salary each table of number indexed by. So here we're storing the salary information, okay, in a table type data type, where it stores the name as value. Here the name salary underscore list first, it is first identifying the salary at the first, while name is not null. While name is not null, it is retrieve the salary and it is moving to the next element. See there. Salary of James is 78,000, 1 lakh, then it is 75,000. Here it is passing the salary list of a the salary list we are added. It stores the value in the form of a key and value. So here Rajnish is a key, value is 60,000. Vinax is a key, value is 75,000. Okay. Is it clear? So first we are defining a type is salary, table of. So here the salary information is stored in a table, and here the reference salary reference is what? Salary underscore list. So in the salary underscore list we are storing the element Rajni 62,000, Minaxi 75,000, Martin 1 lakh, James 78,000. Okay, now it is referencing to the first element. Salary list dot first means it is referred to the first element. Now it is retrieve the element. Okay, it is retrieve the element and it is moving to the cursor to the next element. Before executing this query, first of all, I create a table. Departments as select from that dot. Creating a table. Here I'm creating a table. Then declare type. Department underscore table type is tabular. So here I am defining department underscore table type. Department's name. Okay, so it is retrieve the record from the department table. In which way it is retrieved? In a row basis it is retrieved. So we are defining a row type. Row type it is used for storing the entire row. Whether you don't bother about that, which type of hello you want to retrieve at runtime, then index PLS integer. Then table type reference is department underscore table. Now we are using the PLSQL statement, select star into department table, which it is retrieve a record from the department table type from department, where department ID equals to 10. The DBMS underscore output put line department table 1 ID, then name and manager ID. Department underscore ID. This record it is retrieved 10 RMS system. We're passing department table index 1, department ID, department table 1, references 1, department name, department table 1, manager ID. So when you execute this statement, it is retrieved that information 10 RMS system 200. Here?
Yes, sir.
indexed by table with record option as previously discussed. An associative array that is declared as a table of scalar data type. Associative array, it contains what? It contains the key and value pair. So as previously discussed, an associative array that is declared, that is a table data type. Array that is declared is a table of scalar data type. Scalar data type means which is hold a single value. However, there is often need to store all the column retrieved by a query. The index by table of record option enable one array definition to hold the information about all the field of a database table. It will store all the field, like what are the columns are available in your table, it is retrieved all the fields over. So creating and referencing a table of record. As shown in the associative array example, use row type attribute to declare a record that represents a row in a database table. Okay, so it is representing a row in a database table. It refers to a field within the department table array because each element of the array is record. Then row type data, the difference between row type attribute and composite data type of PLSQL. PLSQL record type can be user defined, whereas row type is implicitly defined the record. PLSQL record type. Okay, when you are defining a PLSQL record, it is a user defined, and row type is a predefined. Row type attribute, it is basically it is used to hold an entire row in a table. The PLSQL record enable you to specify the field and their data type while declaring them. When you use row type, you cannot specify the field of row type attribute. It represents a table row with a field based upon the definition of that table. User defined record are static. When you are defining a user defined record, it is a static, but row type record are dynamic. Means which is getting a value at the runtime, dynamic. They are based on the table structure. If the table structure changes, the record structure also pick up the changes. So type attribute, row type attribute, it is basically, it is used for the dynamic purposes. Suppose whenever you are changing the column definition, like you change the data type of the column, then it is not affected to the variable. So when you change the data type of a column in a table, so there is no need to change the variable data type of a PLSQL. As you are using type attribute and row type attribute, when you use row type attribute, so if you change the entire row column data type, then there is no requirement to change the PLSQL variable. Okay, so it is automatically store the value or implicitly store the value in the variable that defined in the PLS. Declare employee type is a table of employee row type indexed by PLS integer. But defining employee table is table of employee index PLS integer. Maximum count number is 104. Begin for I in 100. Okay, so for I in 100, that is giving you 100 to the maximum count, 100 to 104. Okay. Then select star into my employee table from employee where employee ID equals to I. For employee ID that we are passing as what? As it is starting from 100 and maximum value goes to 104. it is retrieve all the record from 100 to 104. Okay, so first represent to 100, last represent to 104. That is retrieve a record. My table I dot last name. I, it is represent the employee ID. Last name, the last name it is retrieved from here. For that, I'm creating a table, create. It is retrieve the 5 record: King, Butcher, D. Han, Arnold, Unrust,